The greatest danger to American democracy right now is not coming from Russia, China, or North Korea. It is coming from the Republican Party. Only 25% of voters self-identify as Republican, the GOP's worst showing against Democrats since 2012, and sharply down since last November. But those who remain in the party are far angrier, more ideological, more truth-denying, and more racist than Republicans who preceded them. And so are the lawmakers who represent them. Today's Republican Party increasingly is defined not by its shared beliefs, but by its shared delusions. 54 U.S. senators voted in favor of at least considering the House-passed bill to establish a commission to investigate the causes and events of the January 6th insurrection. This was 6 votes short of the number of votes needed for consideration of the House bill. So there will be no investigation. The 54 senators who voted to consider the House bill represent 189 million Americans, or 58% of the American population. The 35 who voted not to represent 104 million Americans, or 32% of the population. In other words, essentially 32% of American voters decided that the nation would not know about what happened to American democracy on January 6th. Furthermore, the 35 who voted against the commission were all Republicans. They did not want such an inquiry because it might jeopardize their chances of gaining a majority of the House or Senate in the 2022 midterm elections. They also wanted to stay in the good graces of Donald Trump, whose participation in that insurrection might have been more fully revealed. 8 of these Republicans voted against certifying Joe Biden as president on January 6th. Some of their constituents were responsible for the insurrection in the first place. The Republican Party is also pursuing new laws in many states, making it harder for likely Democrats to vote, and opposing voting reforms in Congress. It's actively purging any Republican who has had the temerity to criticize Trump. They've removed from her leadership position Liz Cheney, who called Trump's efforts to overturn the election and his role in inciting the deadly January 6th riot the greatest, quote, betrayal by a president of the United States of his office and his oath to the Constitution. Local Republican leaders have either stepped down or been forced out of their party positions for not supporting Trump's baseless election claims or for criticizing the former president's role in inciting the deadly Capitol riot. American democracy is at an inflection point. Senate Democrats must get rid of the filibuster and push through major reforms, voting rights, as well as policies that will enable more Americans in the bottom half to do better. In the 1930s, Franklin D. Roosevelt noted that the survival of American democracy depended on the adoption of policies that comprised the New Deal. In that Depression decade, democracy was under siege around the world, and dictators were on the rise. Joe Biden understands that America and the world face a similar challenge today. And like FDR, Biden is making a strong case that the adoption of his policies will buttress democracy against the forces of tyranny, not only as an example to the rest of the world, but here at home.